To give you some context, I'm going to start this clip with some material I was doing earlier in the show.
Very politically active. For a very long time, my whole adult life, really, I've been trying to get everybody to vote. I think it's super important. I've been telling people it's our civic responsibility to vote. If you don't vote, you can't complain about what happens next. You have to go vote. Everybody has to go vote. Everybody has to go vote. And then I meet more and more people, and I'm like, not everybody. Some people need to stay the fuck home. We need to start posting on Facebook that the election got moved to December. We need to post that. Because if you believe that, we don't need your... You're not a part of this. Just start... Everybody start posting. I'm so excited to go vote on December 32nd and just see what happens. This election is making people lose their mind online. But it's not about who's running. It's about what we have decided to do as a people. Because here's the deal. Crazy has always existed. And what we used to do was we used to suffocate it with silence. That's how you get rid of crazy. You ignore it and it fades away. But for the first time, I don't ever remember before seeing rational people engaging with crazy to the level that's happening right now. Why are we addressing crazy? Ignore crazy. In the real world, we ignore crazy. If someone were out on the street yelling out, Hitler is God, you'd cross the fucking street, wouldn't you? But on Facebook, you're like, here are all the reasons why you're wrong. Like, why would you engage with that person? There should be a cross the street button on Facebook. Wouldn't that be sweet? Someone posts something stupid, be like 31 people cross the street at this post. Dial back to crazy.
I closed with a bit about why I'm a feminist before I ended the show with a Q&A. This clip is a bit different than most of the Heckler clips I have, because the guy who spoke up did so during the Q&A, when I tell people that they're allowed to ask whatever they want. So I'm not mad at him for speaking up, but I am mad at him for what he said. So awful that it totally counts.
Why can't Hillary understand normal thinking?
Why can't Hillary understand normal thinking? Do you really believe that? No, hold on a second. Of all the things you could say about her... No, wait, I am not fucking done. Don't shout me down like you're Donald Trump. Let me finish. You think she can't understand normal thinking? Like, you think that when someone tells her something, she's just like, ah! Like, you think that that's true?
Acronym.
What?
Acronym.
Acronym. Normal, like pot normal?
No, can't understand.
Normal. You're calling her a cunt.
Oh, wow.
Okay, that's wonderful. I just told you that I'm a feminist. And you think you'll impress a room half full of women by calling a woman you don't know a cunt. How did that go for you? Okay. Who are you here with tonight?
My brother and his wife. My wife.
Your wife, your brother, and his wife. Wives. How do you feel about that word? Do you think it describes him more than you? Oh, they applauded. Sir, enjoy your car ride home. I'm kidding, enjoy their car ride home. You're a fucking Uber. This is the world we live in. You know what? I just did the thing I made fun of at the beginning of the show. I just engaged with crazy. I should have heard that question. Just cross the fucking street. That's what I should have done.
Thank you for subscribing to this channel. If you haven't gotten your tickets to the Your Tour yet, do it now. The Your Tour has expanded to 155 cities in 52 countries. If you want to see if I'm coming to your city, just go to theyourtour.com. Pick up those tickets.